Hello dear student friends, welcome to the second unit of Nightingale and the Rose. And as we discussed in unit 1, how the student lamented, he cried for a red rose, and how the nightingale was impressed or motivated, and other characters they didn't pay any attention. Now let us discuss what happened. The nightingale was moved to pity by the young student Sorrow, and what she really does. We had some questions there in unit 1. Let us find the answers to the questions and open your books. Get ready with pen or pencil. Go through the text. Suddenly, she spread her brown wings for flight and soared into the air. She passed through the grove like a shadow, and like a shadow, she sailed across the garden. In the center of the lawn was standing a beautiful rose tree, and when she saw it, she flew over to it and lit upon a spray. "Give me your red rose," she cried, "and I will sing you my sweetest song." But the tree shook its head. "My roses are white," it answered, "as white as the foam of the sea and whiter than the snow upon the mountain. But go to my brother who grows beneath the student's window, and perhaps he will give you what you want." So the nightingale flew over to the rose tree that was growing beneath the student's window. Before going to the text, okay, look at here. The characters. Nightingale is there as in unit 1. Two more characters are here. Rose tree 1, rose tree 2, second. Now the theme is nightingale's request. The nightingale wants to get a red rose for the student. The nightingale wants to help the student. So the nightingale goes from tree to tree, makes request. And what response the trees give? Then there is a tough challenge. And what is nightingale's reaction or nightingale's willingness? Now come to the text again. Suddenly she spread her brown wings. As we have discussed, nightingale is a little brown bird. It has brown wings. And all of a sudden, she spread her brown wings in her helping mission. In her helping mission. Okay. And in her way to find a solution to the student's plight, to the student's suffering. Student ra dukha ko laghav kariba pai kon pratikar kara jai paribo, sethi pai nightingale ready hela. She soared into the air. Soared means flew. Rose into the air. And she passed through the grove like a shadow. And like a shadow she sailed across the garden. Look here. The word like is there. As in unit 1. When we discussed about the qualities of a true lover. Here is dark as night. Here is dark like night. And lips are red. It's a simile as we have discussed in the poems. So the poet, the writer, the novelist, the story writer has used different techniques. He has made it poetic. So instead of prosaic language, he has used poetic language to make the narration more attractive. Soared into the air means rose flew into the air. Passed through the grove like a shadow, and like a shadow she sailed across the garden. It's all of a sudden, just as a shadow disappears, as a shadow vanishes in the presence of the sunlight, the nightingale flew all of a sudden. In the center of the lawn was standing a beautiful rose tree. The nightingale saw a beautiful rose tree in the center of the lawn, and when she saw it, she flew over to it and lit upon a spray. L-I-T, lit means set. Set upon a spray means a branch. The nightingale came down and set on the branch of a rose tree. She requested, "Give me a red rose and I will sing you my sweetest song." It's a condition. Bartering situation. Give and take. You give me something, I will give you. Though the nightingale is a bird, she realizes the human psychology. Nothing can be achieved without pain. No pain, no gain. Then she comes to request, "Give me a red rose and I will sing you my sweetest song." But the tree shook its head, refused. Why? My roses are white. Why the tree refused? Because its roses are white. As white as the foam of the sea. Again, comparison. The roses are white as foam in the sea. And whiter than the snow upon the mountain. As the foam in the ocean, you might have seen the waves beating upon the shore. ଯେତେବେଳେ ସମୁଦ୍ରକୁ ଯାଇଥିବା ଆମେ ଦେଖିଥା ଉତ୍ତାଳ ତରଙ୍ଗ ଉପରକୁ ବେଳାଭୂମି ବାଡ଼େଇ ହେଉଛି ଦେନ୍ ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ହ୍ୱାଇଟ୍ ଇନ୍ କଲର୍ ଏଟ୍ ଦ ଟପ୍ ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ହ୍ୱାଇଟ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ସ୍ନୋ ୟୁ ନୋ ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଭେରି ସିମ୍ପଲ୍ ଥିଙ୍ଗ୍ ହ୍ୱାଇଟ୍ ଇନ୍ କଲର୍ ସୋ ଦ ରୋଜେସ୍ ଆର୍ ହ୍ୱାଇଟ୍ ଲାଇକ୍ ଦ ଫୋମ୍ ଅନ୍ ଦ ସୀ ଆଣ୍ଡ ହ୍ୱାଇଟର୍ ଦେନ୍ ଦ ସ୍ନୋ ଅପନ୍ ଦ ମାଉଣ୍ଟେନ୍ ଇଟ୍ ସମଥିଙ୍ଗ୍ ଡିସ୍ହାର୍ଟେନିଙ୍ଗ୍ ଇଟ୍ ସମଥିଙ୍ଗ୍ ପେନ୍ଫୁଲ୍ ଟୁ ଦ ନାଇଟିଙ୍ଗେଲ୍ ବଟ୍ ଦେର୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ସଲ୍ୟୁସନ୍ Go to my brother, the rose tree suggests. Go to my brother who grows beneath the student's window. Grows beneath the student's window. And perhaps he will give you what you want. So at first, the rose tree speaks something negative, then gives a ray of hope. Asara kirana rochi. So the nightingale flew over to the rose tree that was growing beneath the student's window. Give me a red rose, she cried, and I will sing you my sweetest song. Same condition she put forth. Same condition she spoke to the second rose tree. You give me a red rose, I will sing you my sweetest song because I don't have money. I don't have anything to give you. I don't have anything precious to give you in return. So I will sing my song. In return you give me a red rose. But the second tree also shook its head. Why? What is the condition? What is the reason for denial? My roses are red, it answered, as red as the feet of the dove, and redder than the great fans of coral that wave and wave in the ocean cavern. But the winter has chilled my veins, and the frost has nipped my buds, and the storm has broken my branches, and I shall have no roses at all this year. The second rose tree has red roses, still it declines, it denies. Why? Because something other condition, but before that, what the rose tree describes, how the rose tree describes. My roses are red as the feet of the dove. Dove is a bird, small bird. Usually the feet of the birds are red, and here the feet of the dove is redder. So it is compared to the redness of the feet of the dove, and redder than the great fans of coral. Coral fans, you might have heard in the geography, read in geography, deep in the ocean, they are formed and with a collection of what? Dead animals, remnants of the dead bodies in deep in the ocean, and it is just like a mountain inside the sea, and it is orange red. So, redder than the great fans of coral that wave and wave in the ocean cavern. Coral, in Odia, I am going to say, Prabala Prachiro. The wave and wave in the ocean cavern. The waves of the sea have waved them, means gathered them in plenty, heaped them in plenty in the ocean cavern. Ocean cavern means deep inside the ocean, the waves have collected them. ସମୁଦ୍ର ଅତଳ ଗର୍ଭ ମଧ୍ୟରେ ସଂଗୃହିତ ହେଇ ରହିଛି ବଟ୍ ଦ ୱିଣ୍ଟର ହେଜ୍ ଚିଲ୍ଡ ମାଇ ଭେନ୍ସ ଓକେ ଦେର୍ ଇଜ୍ ରେଡ୍ ରେଡ୍ ରୋଜ୍ ବଟ୍ ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦ ପ୍ରୋବ୍ଲେମ୍ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ୱିଣ୍ଟର ହେଜ୍ ଚିଲ୍ଡ ଦ ଭେନ୍ସ ଦେନ୍ ରୋଜ୍ ଟ୍ରି ଫିଲ୍ସ ନମ୍ ଇନ୍ଆକ୍ଟିଭ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଫ୍ରଷ୍ଟ ହେଜ୍ ନିପ୍ଡ ମାଇ ବର୍ଡ୍ସ ଫ୍ରଷ୍ଟ ମିନ୍ସ ଡ୍ୟୁ ହେଜ୍ ନିପ୍ଡ ଡ୍ୟାମେଜ୍ ଦ ବର୍ଡ୍ସ ଦ ଭେନ୍ସ ଆର୍ ଚିଲ୍ଡ ନମ୍ ଶିଥିଳ ହେଇଯାଇଛି ଆଣ୍ଡ ଫ୍ରଷ୍ଟ ହେଜ୍ ଡ୍ୟାମେଜ୍ ଦ ବର୍ଡ୍ସ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଷ୍ଟର୍ମ ହେଜ୍ ବ୍ରୋକନ୍ ମାଇ ବ୍ରାଞ୍ଚେସ୍ ଆଇ ସାଲ୍ ହେଭ୍ ନୋ ରୋଜେସ୍ ଏଟ୍ ଅଲ୍ ଦିସ୍ ଇୟର୍ ନୋ ରେଡ୍ ରୋଜ୍ ସୋ ଦ ସେକେଣ୍ଡ ରୋଜ୍ ଟ୍ରୀ ହେଜ୍ ରେଡ୍ ରୋଜେସ୍ ବଟ୍ ଇଟ୍ ସ୍ପିକ୍ସ ଆବାଉଟ୍ ଦ ଇନାବିଲିଟି ନାଓ ଦ ଡେସ୍ପେରେସନ୍ ଦ ନାଇଟିଙ୍ଗେଲ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଡେସ୍ପେରେଟ୍ ହତାଶ ହେଇଯାଉଛି One red rose is all I want. Only one red rose, cried the nightingale. Is there no way by which I can get it? So the nightingale is desperate. The nightingale is dedicated. The nightingale is determined to get a red rose for the student at any cost. Jena tena prakare se rose te paiba pain chauchi, student pai. Tena pachauchi, is not there a way by which I can get it? The reply of the rose tree is, "There is a way," answered the tree. "But it is so terrible that I dare not tell it to you." "Yes, there is a way." The second rose tree gives hope, assurance. "Yes, there is a way. But it's so terrible, I dare not tell it to you. It's so terrible, it's so painful, it's so horrible, I dare not tell it to you. Ete bhayankar, ete jantranadayaka, mu kahi paribi nahi." "Tell it to me," said the nightingale. "I am not afraid." Look at the determination of the nightingale. "Tell it to me, I am not afraid." The nightingale is not afraid of any situation, any hurdles, any ordeals, or any challenge. "Jahan bhi ho, mu taku help karibi." Now, the tree. "If you want a red rose," said the tree, "you must build it out of music by moonlight and stain it with your own heart's blood. You must sing to me with your breast against a thorn. All night long you must sing to me, and the thorn must pierce your heart, and your lifeblood must flow into my veins and become mine." Look at the words. Look at the words. "If you want a red rose, you must build it out of music by moonlight." All through the moonlight. Only in the night. During the night, you have to build it. You have to grow it with your music. "You must build it out of music by moonlight. If the sun comes or if the sun rises, you cannot get." So the condition is, you have to grow the rose by the night. And stain it. You grow it with your music, then stain it. Make it colorful with your own heart's blood. Donate your blood or make the rose red with your heart's blood. "You must sing to me." Not only that condition, you have to sing all through the night. It is a tough challenge. Okay, nightingale is a singing bird. She can sing for any length. But another condition is there. You must sing and you must donate your blood. Another is there. "You must sing to me with your breast against a thorn." Condition number one is to sing all through the night. Condition number two is to stain it with heart's blood. And how to stain it? How to donate blood? The nightingale has to sit on a thorn. The nightingale has to put or set her breast on a thorn. And the thorn must pierce her heart. The thorn must go deep into her heart. Hrudaya ku bheda kariba sei kanta. Kanta upare ta chhati ku rakhibo aa sei kanta ta hrudaya ku bheda kariba. "And your lifeblood must flow into my veins." Your lifeblood must flow into my veins and become mine. That means the rose tree says, the rose tree puts the condition, as the veins are chilled, the rose tree wants to get the warmth, make the veins warm with the warm blood of the nightingale. Condition number one, sing all through the night, then set her breast on a thorn. The thorn must pierce or go deep into the heart, and life blood would flow through that. "Death is a great price to pay for a red rose," cried the nightingale. "Death for a red rose? No gold, no jewelry, no money, but sacrificing the life. Anyone can be hesitant. Anyone can be hesitant." Bidhagrasta rejo. Kola pate paiba pai jibanat utsarga kariba, jibantyaga kariba, jibanata bahumulya. Cried the nightingale. "And life is very dear to all. Yet, love is better than life. And what is the heart of a bird compared to the heart of a man?" This dialogue speaks about undeterred attention, undeterred mentality of the nightingale. Undeterred. Nightingale pachaguncha deu nahi. Nightingale raji achi. "Death is a great price to pay for a red rose." Why? Life is very dear to all. No one is ready to die. No one is ready to die because life is dear to all. But on the other side, the nightingale reflects, what? Love is better than life. Love is better than life. We might have seen the examples. If one boy or girl is refused, then he or she may commit suicide or may take drastic step. Because for him or her, love is greater than anything. So here the Nightingale speaks the same voice. Love is better than life. And again, what is the heart of a bird compared to the heart of a man? So which is precious? The heart of a bird is not costlier, not valuable as compared to the heart of a man. In the voice of the Nightingale, in the words of the Nightingale, a man's heart is more precious. She thinks like that. Now, what do you think? Is the Nightingale ready to sacrifice? Yes, the words, the dialogue or the speech speaks that. So, she spread her brown wings for flight and soared into the air. She swept over the garden like a shadow, and like a shadow, she sailed into her prey. Thinking that, okay, mentally she was ready. She was ready to sacrifice because her mission was to help the student at any cost. Thinking that, having strong decision, she spread her brown wings for flight, udano, udibaparadi, and soared into the air, rose into the air, flew into the air. She swept over the garden, she flew over the garden like a shadow, and like a shadow, she sailed into her tree. She has decided to sacrifice her life, to help the student get a red rose. Now, she flies back to her tree, to her nest. Why? If the Nightingale has taken the decision to sacrifice her life, then why does the Nightingale or why does the bird fly back to her nest? That is the suspense, and that will be discussed in the third unit. I hope you might have understood. With this, I conclude. Thank you all. Thank you very much.